स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम हीराचंद भोई, लेक्चरर इन मैथमेटिक्स एट गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज सोलापुर. सो टुडे वी विल लर्न द कोर्स बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स विच हैज कोड 22103. सो दिस इज फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग. दिस सब्जेक्ट इज कॉमन फॉर ऑल ब्रांचेस. इट इज कॉमन टू ऑल for first year, first semester. So for this paper, total 5 units are there. So first unit is algebra, second unit is trigonometry, third unit is coordinate geometry, fourth is mensuration, and fifth one is statistics. So already I have discussed about these units in our last session. So these 5 units, this paper total is for 100 marks. So out of 100, 70 is for end semester examination, which is conducted at the end of examination, and 30 marks is for progressive assessment. So progressive assessment, it contains total dividation of these 30 is as 20 plus 10. So this 20 is nothing but there are 2 internal tests which is conducted on unit 1-2 and unit 3-4. In this way there are 2 unit tests, each carry 20 marks. So average of these 2 tests is nothing but this 20 marks, and this 10 mark is for micro project. So there are list of groups which is given in your syllabus. On that list of micro projects, so on that list you have to prepare one micro project in your group. So that is calculated for 10 marks. It is individual plus personal group activity. So in this way, your total basic mathematics course is for 100 marks. So today we will start unit 1, algebra. So in this unit, there are total 4 chapters. So first chapter is logarithm. Second chapter is determinant. Third chapter is matrix. And fourth chapter is partial fraction. These 4 chapters are in unit 1. So we'll first start chapter 2, determinant. So now we start chapter 2, determinant. So first we will see the definition of determinant. So determinant is arrangement of You see the definition of determinant. It is arrangement of n by n numbers, which may be real, imaginary, or complex, in n rows. Rows are nothing but horizontal lines and in n columns. Columns are nothing but what? Vertical lines between pair of brackets. So, bar brackets. So, this is the definition of what? Determinant. So, are you getting my point? Once again, I will recall. It is arrangement of n by n numbers which may be real, imaginary or complex in n rows. Rows are nothing but what? Horizontal lines and in n columns. Columns are nothing but what? Vertical lines between pair of bar brackets. Okay. So, first I will show you an example of 2 by 2 determinant. So, this is nothing but D. So, first I will write A, B. So, these are elements which are present in what? Horizontal lines. So, these are nothing but what? Row 1. C, D. These are elements which are present in between what? Horizontal lines. So, this is nothing but what? Row 2. Okay. So, are you getting my point? So, total number of rows are what? 1 row, 2 row. So, now I will tell you what is column. Column is nothing but what? Elements which are present in vertical line. Vertical line is nothing but what? The elements which are A and C. So, this is nothing but what? Column 1. Next, B, D. So, this is nothing but what? Column 2. Which is nothing but what? Second vertical line. Okay. So, according to the definition, arrangement of n by n numbers. So, I am here taking example of 2 by 2. So, total number of rows are what? 2 rows, R1, R2 and 2 columns. Okay. Between pair of bar brackets. So, bar bracket is nothing but just the straight line. Okay. So, this is nothing but what? Bar bracket. So, this is what? Determinant of order 2 by 2. Okay. So, you know that determinant of 2 by 2, it is simply calculated as multiplication of A and D minus multiplication of B and C. Means this value is calculated by A into D minus B into C. Okay. So, I will give you one example. Suppose we have to calculate a determinant of 1, 2, 3, 4. See, check. Here your bracket should be only bar, means straight line. Okay. So, determinant of 1, 2, 3, 4, it is calculated as, according to this definition, this is product of 1 into 4 minus product of 2 into 3. Okay. So, first multiply this. 4 into 1 is 4 minus 2 into 3 is what? Yes, it is 6. Okay. So, 4 minus 6 is nothing but what? Minus 2. Yes. So, this is the value of this given determinant. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So, are you getting my point? In first row, elements are what? 1, 2. In second row, elements are what? Yes. Tell me. In second row, 3, 4. Yes. Then, in first column, you can check here. I am denoting it by in first column, elements are what? 1, 3. And in second column, 2, 4. So, this is nothing but what? Determinant of order 2 by 2. Why? Because it contains 2 rows and 2 columns. Okay? Are you getting my point? Okay? So, this is what? A definition of determinant. So, here there are some applications of this determinant, which is nothing but we can solve simultaneous equation. I will explain you in short application of determinant. We can solve what? Simultaneous equation by using Cramer's rule. Already you have solved, maybe you have solved this determinant to solve simultaneous equation by using Cramer's rule. And next, to second, check consistency of equation, means whether the given simultaneous equation have solution or not, you can check by using this determinant. Next application is whether matrix is singular or not. So we'll see the concept of matrix in next chapter. So that matrix are singular or not, we can check. Yes, are you getting my point? Then linearly dependence of vectors. Okay, so in this way there are so many applications of this determinant concept. Okay, so now we will move to determinant of order 3 by 3. So before going to that, just I will give you the determinant of sign for order 2 by 2. So for order 2 by 2, determinant of sign is given by plus minus minus plus. So keep note. Yes, so this is determinant of sign for order 2 by 2. You can simply calculate it as, what is the position of this? This position is nothing but it is situated in first row and first column. Okay, so first row, first column means position addition, it becomes what? 1 plus 1 is 2. So that 2 is even. So therefore, this has positive sign. Okay. Next, take minus. It is situated in what? First row and second column. Okay. So this has position what? First row and second column. Okay. So therefore, 1 plus 2 is 3. So it is odd. In this way, odd gives minus sign. So therefore, this position has what? Minus sign. So in this way, you can calculate determinant of sign. Or keep remember, just it is what? 2 by 4. 2 by 2 it is plus minus minus plus. Okay? False. Yes? Now you start determinant of order 3 by 3. Yes? So determinant of order 3 by 3. It is just, it should be what? It should be arrangement of total 3 by 3 means 9 numbers. So for example, I am taking here A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. So total how many numbers are there? 9. Okay. So determinant is of order 3 by 3 is arrangement of n by n numbers in n rows. So are you getting my point? How many rows are there? Total? Yes, 3 rows. Then next, how many columns are there? Total 3 columns. So arrangement of n by n numbers in 3 rows and 3 columns. Okay? So are you getting it? So this is nothing but determinant of order 3 by 3. So to calculate value of determinant of order 3 by 3, now we have to see some terminologies. So first we will discuss what? Determinant of sign. So determinant of sign for 3 by 3. Will you tell me what is the position of first element? Yes, so this position, what is the position of first element? It is, yes, this is nothing but your R1, R2, R3, C1, C2, C3. The position of first element is what? First row, first column. Means 1 plus 1, it is what? 2. So therefore it has plus sign. Okay, next, position of second element, this is nothing but what? First row and second column. So 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 is what? Odd. So therefore, it has minus sign. So in this way you can simply calculate. So this is what plus minus plus minus plus minus, and next it should be what plus minus plus. So this is what determinant of sine for order 3 by 3. Okay. So now we will move to what minor of an element. So minor of element, it is nothing but what? Suppose I have to calculate minor of A1. Okay. So minor of A1 is nothing but just delete this row hole and this column. So you will remain with what? Yes, B2, C2, B3, C3. So take determinant of this. So this is nothing but what? Your minor of element A1. It is nothing but what? What is the definition of minor of A1? So minor of A1 is nothing but just delete that row and that column. You will remain with only what? B2, C2 and B3, C3. So this is nothing but what? Minor of A1. Means what will be the definition? Minor of A-ith element is nothing but delete I-th row and J-th column. You will get minor of A-i-j. Okay? So this will be what? Minor of element. Again I will explain minor of. Suppose we will take now minor of B2. Okay? So minor of B2 is what? Minor of B2 is nothing but just what? Delete this second row. Okay? So are you getting my point? If you delete the second row and delete the second column, you will remain with what? Only A1, C1 and A3, C3. Are you getting my point? Yes? So minor of B2 is nothing but delete this whole row 2 and whole column C2. So you will remain with what? A1, C1 and A3, C3. A1, C1 and A3, C3. So determinant of this is nothing but what? Minor of B2. Okay? So now you know that. How we will calculate of determinant of 2 by 2? Yes? What is determinant of 2 by 2? Just it is multiplication of what? B2 C3 minus C2 B3. Okay? Next, in the same fashion, minor of B2 is nothing but determinant of this. So determinant of this, it is calculated by what? A1 C3 minus A3 C1. Okay? So in this way, we can calculate minor of elements. Okay? So now we will move to the definition of, yes, now we will move the definition of cofactor of an element. Yes, cofactor of an element. So these terminologies will require to definition of determinant of order 3 by 3. Therefore, we'll see first, we will, yes, minor of an element and then cofactor of an element. Okay. So suppose I have to calculate cofactor of element. So I am taking here, this is nothing but what? A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. Okay. And again I will require the determinant of sine, which is nothing but already I have discussed with you. I will write here, it is what? Plus minus plus minus plus minus and plus minus plus. It is what? Determinant of, yes, determinant of sine for 3 by 3. Okay. So suppose cofactor of an element. So it is simple. Cofactor of an element, it is what? Just minus 1 raised to I plus j into minor of an element. Okay? So it is what cofactor of an element is nothing but suppose I have to calculate cofactor of A1. Okay. So cofactor of A1 is nothing but it is what? What is determinant of sign here? Yes, it is plus. Yes, are you getting my point? In this position, what will be the sign? It is plus. So right here, plus into what is minor of this element? Already I told you, minor of A1 is what? Yes, or you can write simply what? It is minor of A1. So it is simply what? Cofactor of A1 is nothing but what? Minor of A1. Are you getting my point? So since it has a positive determinant of sign, so it will remain as it is at minor of A1. Okay. So now we'll check what is the cofactor of, yes? Cofactor of B2. Yes. So are you getting it? Cofactor is nothing but, yes, just multiply its minor with its determinant of sign. Okay. So cofactor of B2. See. So B2 is at what? Again this.